Hi, in this video I will show you some ways in which you can add some reference images in ZBrush. For the first way, you will need to have your mesh ready to sculpt. In this case, I created a sphere. Press T to enter edit mode, and then click on Make Polymesh 3D to be ready to sculpt. Once you have done this, turn on the grid. Then we can go to the draw menu and open the front back section. There will be two options below, map 1 and map 2. Map 1 is for the front image and map 2 for the back, like it appears on the title of the section. If we want to add an image behind our mesh, we click on map 1, click on import, select the image that we want, and it will appear on the viewport on a plane behind our mesh. To adjust the image, we will need to go to the draw menu in the front back section. Here we can modify the scale, horizontal and vertical position, and the rotation. Now if we add an image in the map 2 section, we can see that if we go to the back view, the image changes to the one added in the map 2 section. This is the same process for the other options, in up, down and left, right. If you want to hide the image, you just need to turn off the grid. Now, for the other way to add reference images, that is the one I prefer, it's with the spotlight. For this, we need to go to the texture menu, click on import and choose the image that you want. Then we select the image in this section, and this will activate the options below. Click on the Add to Spotlight button. Close the lightbox with comma. Note that I imported a PNG image with transparency. This is more comfortable. If you import an image with a background, you will be seeing the whole image and it will take more space that you can use to see your sculpt. After you add the image to the spotlight, you will see this tool wheel. If we click and drag on the inner circle, we will be able to move the wheel itself. But if we click and drag in the area between the tools and the inner circle, we will be able to move the image. If we press the Z key, we can hide the tool wheel. Also, for you to be able to sculpt with this image on the spotlight, you will need to select the brush you want to sculpt with, go to the brush menu, under samples, turn off the spotlight projection. Now you will be able to sculpt. To hide the image, we have to press Shift and Z. I use this when I want my model to be as close to the concept as possible. For example, in this project, I put my model in the right position to be as close as possible to the concept. With the function of opacity in the tool wheel, I lower down the opacity of the reference image. I scale it to be as close as possible to the model. And then I put the reference image over the mesh. Make sure it's as close as possible to the image. Turn back the opacity to the full. Now I start to turn on and off the image to see what is different from the concept and the model. This is a very easy way to see the differences you have in your model based on the concept. I hope this was useful. I will be making videos of the process of 3D assets. So if you're interested in this, subscribe, leave a comment and like the video. See you in the next one.